Morning. Wow, we are already on morning boost number 23. And today we are going to talk about I can't afford it. And I get it. And let me help you explain how you can and actually possibly save some money in doing so. Let's do it. Get started with some dancing. Good morning. Good morning. Come in and say who you are. I see some people popping on. Love it. I'm so excited to talk to you about this today. Powerful stuff. I'll make another road myself. You were made for something more. You were fighting for. This could be all you've been looking for. This could be all you've been looking for. Absolutely. All right, we're going to jump in. Let me fix my camera. Such a good song. All right, so I am so blurry this morning. It'll hopefully focus. Let's see. Focus, camera, focus. Do you ever feel like that? Like you're walking around in life and feeling blurry? Okay, come on, camera. Come on, camera. I might have to pop off and come back on if it doesn't work. Good morning, Samantha. So glad you're here. Trying to get my camera to focus. We are going to talk about some good stuff. Oh, there we go. Yay. Okay, we're going to be talking today about, I hear a lot of women say, and trust me, this has been me in the past too, is I can't afford it. I can't afford to buy healthy food, to, you know, work out or get a gym membership, or I can't afford coaching, or I can't afford whatever it is, Tupperware to get some food prep done and have healthy food and take it with me. I get it. I have so been there, and today I really want to give you some mindset shifts about that and also help you find a way. I do believe, I'm a firm believer that when there's a will, there's a way. So that's really the first thing we want to check in with is when it comes to healing your relationship with food and feeling great in your body and overcoming emotional eating, how invested emotionally are you in that? Is that something that truly you want to have? We have to talk about that first, because when we really get a clear why, which is the first two modules in the Living Blissfully Healthy program I've created, then the how, it's easier. The how starts to show up. So that's the first thing, is getting really clear around why you want to overcome this. And a good way to start looking at that is looking at what staying stuck and doing nothing is actually costing you. And we can look at that on two levels. One way we can say, what is it costing me emotionally? It's costing me, a lot of women I hear, that's costing me my self-esteem, my confidence. It's costing me in a way where my energy is lower. I can't think straight because I'm not eating healthy foods. It's costing me in my relationships because I'm not feeling confident and secure, or I'm withdrawing, or I'm getting depressed, or I feel anxious. So all things like that we want to take a look at, right? So, sorry, a little bit itchy this morning with my eyes. So that's the first place. And really, I would love to hear from you. If you want to comment on this, what is doing nothing, staying stuck in emotional eating costing you? I want to talk about that emotionally. Emotionally, what is it costing you? And get clear on that. So comment below. I'd love to hear about what that is for you. So once we get clear on that piece of it first. We always want to start with that emotional part first and not this beating self up around, I should be able to do this. But first, we want to get clear on that. And is it really truly important to you right now, this time in life, to overcome and heal emotional eating? Is that really important to you? Because where we spend our money, where we spend our time, is a true reflection of where our priorities are. And so the other part of this emotionally that keeps a lot of clients stuck in deciding that I can't afford to do whatever it takes to heal emotional eating and to be healthy, whether that's the food, whether it's the Tupperware to do, take your food with you, whether it's the lunchbox, whether it's the water bottle, whether it's coaching, whatever it might be, I can't afford it. The second part is being afraid of how it will impact other people, meaning that people pleasing is getting in the way of you feeling valuable and worthy enough to invest, whatever, again, that looks like. So that can really be a mindset blocker for a lot of women, where they use the obstacle, I can't afford it, because really underneath that is, oh, when we dive a little deeper, I'm like, tell me more about that. What does that mean, you can't afford it? Sometimes it's, well, my husband would not be happy with the amount of money I would want to invest, and I really need to invest for the support that I need. Or if I dine out less, if that's a route you want to go, well, then others may not be happy with that, and my spouse or my children won't be happy about that. So some of it really is that people pleasing that keeps people stuck in the obstacle, I can't afford it. So now that we've looked at those two pieces, we are looking at, why is it that you want to do this? Emotionally, what is it costing you to stay stuck in emotional eating and doing nothing about it? And now let's talk about physically. Like, what is it costing you physically to continue just doing the same thing that you've been doing, or doing nothing? Physically, it'll probably end up costing you your mental health, being depressed or anxious, feeling hopeless and helpless, and that will trickle into all areas of life, relationships, work, just mood colors everything in life. A mood, which is a sustained way of being, whether a couple hours or just days or weeks or months, a mood is an emotional state that just colors everything. So if you're feeling shameful about your body and your relationship with food, it will absolutely manifest out in other areas and have a lot of blockers in your life. So how is it costing you physically? Maybe you're eating foods you know that don't work for your body, but maybe you're not sure what foods they are, or you might even know specifically what foods are causing you to have issues in your body, and yet you're still eating those foods. Classic emotional attachment to food. I see that all the time. So maybe you're having more acid reflux, or you're having more GI issues, or constipation, or the vice versa, or that, or maybe a little bit of both, and it alternates. Maybe you're having acne issues, maybe having fatigue. Ugh, fatigue and headaches and muscle aches and GI issues are the most common things I see with clients, because we're eating foods that maybe are not working for your body. So even though you may know, like, if I eat this, I may not feel my best, you're still finding yourself doing it. How is that costing you? And then in the long run, if you do nothing in 1 year, where will you be? How will you be in your health? In 5 years, if you do nothing or you do the same thing you've been doing, where will you be? And is that time wasted in that emotional state, focused on obsession with food and weight and maybe not having the vitality you deserve? Is that worth it? Is that worth it? My guess would be no. So these are the emotional obstacles that really can get in the way, where a lot of people will use the obstacle, I can't afford it. And whether that's intentionally, and most of the time it's subconscious, because those are emotional things we need to face. Now, let's take a look at the other side, which is literally financial. Okay, that's the fun part. I like that part too. So when we say I can't afford it financially, I really want to encourage you to take a look at where you might be spending your money that it's not getting you closer to the health that you want to be. And through coaching or through making little baby shifts, one at a time, a lot of the clients I work with actually end up saving money in the long run, even after their coaching support, whatever level they want to get for their services with me. And the reason is that a lot of clients will emotionally eat or dine out in a way to let those emotional eating types, right? The I deserve it or the screw it eating. When maybe you've had a long week and we're getting close to that time when a lot of people will fall off the wagon on Thursdays or Fridays and then just say, oh, it's been a long week, screw it. I'm just gonna go dine out and get Chinese food or pizza or whatever it might be because it's been stressful. Screw it, and that's screw it eating or I deserve it eating. Okay, so then what we can do, if you want to look at this, totally your choice, but it's so empowering for clients who choose to look at this. How many times do you dine out in a week? And I'm not saying you can't dine out. You can totally choose to dine out and keep doing whatever it is that you're doing with how often you might dine out. We're not taking away the food, okay? That's what's most important. All we're doing is let's get some realistic and a rational way of looking at it. We talked about the more of the emotional side. Now we're also going to take a look at the rational side, because when we look at both sides, then we tend to make a better decision that is a balanced decision about what we want to do. So maybe that's coffee. Oh my goodness, I myself love coffee and I like to track how I'm spending my income. And I realized that this last month, okay, I've spent a little bit more money on coffee than I realized. And that could have been enough money to almost buy one of those new, I want to say it starts with an N, machine that I really, really want. You just put the pod in and then it makes this like espresso. So yummy. I love espresso. Love coffee. And so I was like, wow, that's powerful information. Okay, what do I want to do with that? And I get to choose. It's not about shaming yourself or putting yourself down. It's just about saying, huh, okay, that's not really how I want to be spending the money. Okay, so what am I going to do with that? And then there's a way to find to create more money for that. I could put that money towards a yoga membership that I so want, a hot yoga membership. So there we go. We just found some money. That is me investing in, yes, I do have money and I'm choosing where I spend it. And so I want to choose it to spend it in a way of that's going to get me actually healthier. And so I do have the money. I just need to choose how I'm going to spend it. So that's an example. But dine outs, I have so many clients that will come in and say, I probably dine out about 2 times a week, 3 times a week, and even some that are like 5 times a week or every day. Okay, let's tally that up and say how often would you feel good about continuing to dine out? What would be in alignment with your value system? Do you want to continue dining out twice a week? Let's say you dine out 5 times a week. What would feel good? Well, let's say twice a week would be more of a healthier way that would be in alignment with how you want to be living your life. Fabulous. So then we can take a look and say, well, how those other 3 dine outs, maybe you're spending $25 in a dine out there. Maybe it's $50. And so 25, let's take that. It's easy math. 75. I'm going to get my calculator out. $75 a week. Oh my gosh. If you take down how much you're eating there, eating out, but still eating out some, $75 a week times 4 is $300 a month that you just saved. And what we can do is help you find some ways to eat delicious food at home that doesn't take you a lot of time and actually save that money. So you can invest it in whatever you choose to do, whether that's to put it in savings, pay off debt. Maybe it is to invest in some coaching or some healthier foods or the Tupperware you need so you can transport your foods. I love Tupperware. So that's an example of how we can actually find the money. But first, we have to be real with ourselves and say, the way that I'm spending money, is that in alignment with my values? How does that make me feel when I actually look at the hard number? It is a reality check. Absolutely a reality check. So as another example, yesterday was a super busy day for me. And I had the thought, I'm just going to go and get a veggie burger at my favorite vegan restaurant. Ugh. And I know that that veggie burger is probably $13 and it's yummy, yummy, yummy. And I do love to dine out here every once in a while, and it happens, and you're not wrong or horrible for doing it. It's totally normal. And we want to dine out sometimes because it's a treat. Absolutely. And we need to learn how to navigate through that without binging. So I just used my tools, and absolutely, I could go and eat that. And then I thought about the time. Well, if I go there, it's probably going to take them 10 minutes to make the veggie burger. It's going to take 5 minutes to drive there and 5 minutes to drive back. Like, whoa, that actually might save me more time. And then I'm not going to feel so rushed if I actually stop by my home and heat up the food prep item that I had. And so I went home, because I looked at the emotional and the rational side, and I went home and I heated up the food that I had prepped on Sunday for myself and my kids, and it was yummy. I saved time. I wasn't rushed. Saved over $13 just in that experience. So that, and I felt better, you know, emotionally speaking. So all of that are ways that we get to choose. So I hope that the biggest thing you're taking aside from this is a sense of empowerment. Okay, this is not about shaming or judging yourself. Please do not judge yourself about how you're spending your money. It's about having a look at how you're spending your money and deciding, I do have money. We all have money. We all have money. And am I choosing to spend it in a way that is helping me get healthier, right? It's helping me be happier and healthier. And if it's not, let's set up a time to chat, and we can also talk about this so you can have more of a personalized plan. I love doing this type of thing of helping clients really find the money to be healthy, whether it's, again, eating more healthier foods and having more veggies available, or doing some food prep to save money. Food prep does not have to be part of your lifestyle, but it can be. And whether it's, doing whatever step it is that's going to help you get healthier. Same thing with like getting nails done. I have chosen not to get my nails done, although I love doing that. I've chosen not to get my nails done for a little bit so that I can shift some of that income towards getting more fruits and veggies in my babies, you know, in my kiddos. And I get to choose that, and I feel great about that. And I can do my nails at home, you know, for right now. And or you can find a technical college that does those types of services, including hair, at a much more discounted price, and they're equally as awesome and wonderful. Wow, that can save money. So there's lots of ways. I love brainstorming with clients. So if you want some help with this, let's set up a time to chat. Okay, so the biggest takeaway that I'm hoping you get out of this is I choose how I'm going to spend my money. I get to choose. So instead of saying, I can't afford it, I would love to invite you to say, I'm choosing not to spend money on this right now. Maybe it's on the money to buy healthy foods. I'm choosing that. That's putting you back in the driver's seat, okay? Or I'm choosing not to spend money and invest in a coaching program right now. That's a huge shift. Or it could be, I'm choosing to look at my finances so that I can shift some things and find the money to be my happiest, healthiest self. And the last thing I would love to invite you to do is, let's just pretend that we zoom ahead in life and you're 90 years old, sitting on your rocking chair, and you're reflecting back in your life. What are you going to wish that you have done? You're going to want to have all the vitality possible. And how we take care of our body and our emotional state allows us to have more vitality for longer in life. And when you take great care of yourself, you're going to show up as a more powerful woman or man for the people in your life. So in a lot of ways, I want to invite you to think about, I can't afford not to do this. Whatever that looks like, I cannot afford not to do this. And know that you are worthy of investing in whatever it takes to be the happiest, healthiest you. There have been times, and I get the struggle, there have been times in my life where things were extremely tight and I did not know how I was going to afford things that I wanted to be healthy and in a lot of ways were downright needs. Needs for me and my kiddos. And what we can do is we can find a way. So if you have a certain amount of income coming in into your from your job, from Social Security, from whatever it is, if you're on a fixed income, yes, awesome. And you still have a choice. You still have a choice. You could go out and get a second job if you really wanted to. If this was super important to you, you could choose to do that. You could choose to start one of those social, what are they called, network marketing companies and get some extra income on the side. You could choose to babysit. You could choose to go help a friend and maybe clean up her home a little bit for her. You could choose to barter with some people for things that maybe you could swap for so you can open up some income. You are not stuck in your circumstance. Financially speaking, you can do things. There are ways. There's jobs out there that you can get, actually, like a second job where you could get paid to sleep. I know of one specifically where you go there and they just need a second body and you could get paid to actually sleep there. So while you're sleeping, you could get paid. Like, I know that's kind of an extreme example, but I just want you to know you are not stuck. You could get a second job. You can make more income. You can shift the amount of money that you're having in certain areas and shift your priorities. You are not stuck in your circumstances. So think outside the box. I went to go work on a farm at one point a couple years ago because I wanted to make sure my kids had healthy foods and fruits and vegetables because at that point, I chose to put money towards other things that we needed for our basic needs. So I chose to work in the farm in the middle of the summer so that for 3 hours, like every Wednesday morning, so that I could bring home a whole bunch of fruits and vegetables for my kiddos. When there's a will, there's a way. And so I felt amazing and great about it. And it was actually a great thing to be able to work on the farm. It was really, really cathartic experience. It was awesome. It was really awesome. And so guys, you are not a victim to your circumstances. And I just want you to be empowered. Not only that, by shifting to Blissfully Healthy here, that is why I've created the $97 program also. It's 30 days to really jumpstart your mindset. Things like this and the first two sessions where we get really clear on your why so that you feel grounded and solid in your journey. Okay, so this is $97. That's probably a shift of maybe two dine outs. If you shift your coffee intake like me, then you can afford it for sure. And when there's a will, there's a way. So that $97 program, that is partly why I wanted to create it, so that it is at more of a price point that people can give it a try, test drive it, see if it's for you. And then if you want to continue, great, let's set up a chat and we can find a way together of how you can afford ongoing coaching so you can be the happiest, healthiest you now all the way until you're 90. Right? Or after as well. My goal is 108 or more or something better. So there's a will. So I hope this speaks to you. This has been so fun. You can do this. You are not a victim to your circumstances. You have choices. You have possibilities. Do whatever it takes for you to be happy and healthy. Until we chat again tomorrow morning, you are invited to stop dieting and start living. Because a blissfully healthy lifestyle does not have an expiration date. And I'll talk to you soon. Bye.